course, we would want to thank Beats for inviting us over to be part of this project launch on digital economy. So what I'll be doing this morning is to share with you the advocacies that we have actually launched or trying to spread across the country. So what I'll be presenting to you this morning is, in fact, the one that we have launched last September 6th at the BSP headquarters together with BSP Governor Espinilla and Securities and Exchange Commission Chairman Tess Herbosa. So, in a recent report published about last month, no, the Philippines leads Asia in financial inclusion, ranking 7th among the 26 countries. This is according to the 2017 Brookings Financial and Digital Inclusion Project by the Center for Technology Innovations. The top six were Kenya, of course, because of the M-Pesa, Brazil, Mexico, Colombia, and South Africa. In that report, the scorecard said used to measure those countries was based on four dimensions of financial inclusion. So one is country commitment, second would be mobile capacity, third would be regulatory environment, and lastly, adoption of traditional and digital financial services. So the Philippines received its highest scores of 100% in the country commitment and regulatory environment categories, while it scored 94% in terms of mobile capacity, but only got 42% in the area of adoption. So it's all about the lack or poor adoption by the target market. That's our people, the Filipinos. So we have a choice to make our lives better. As what former United Nations Security General Ban Ki-moon rightly puts, and I quote, "Empowerment is critical for attaining the future we want," unquote. Most of the poor in developed countries thrive in an informal economy. Despite being in that state, they still have the propensity and capability to save, to borrow, to be covered by insurance, to start a micro-investment, and of course, to make payments for their daily expenses. Unfortunately, for most of them, having no access to formal financial services would make them susceptible to tapping their families and friends for a loan, pawn shops, usurious money lenders, or just keep their hard-earned money under the mattresses. In fact, the Philippines is only the only country in the world where you have the most number of 62%, most number of Filipinos borrowing from family and friends. So the unfortunate thing there is that you can't choose your relatives. No? So if you don't pay off, hindi ka nakapapansin ng kamag-anak mo. So hindi ka na-invite sa mga birthday parties. Okay. So what we are trying to do here is the fact that we are in partnership with regulators, specifically the BSP, on how we could push financial inclusive growth. So how do we now address the issue on adoption? How can we help people, regardless of income level, help themselves to have access to and can effectively use the appropriate financial services they need to improve their lives? Inspired by what I call the four P's in promoting inclusive digital finance, one has to have purpose to make a difference, passion to bring about that change, positivity to believe that it will happen, and perseverance to sustain such vision and execute it to fruition. The advocacy will stand on three pillars: on innovation, interoperability, and inclusivity, anchored on the principles of the National Strategy for Financial Inclusion and the objectives of the National Retail Payment System. Ikaw man ay kapamilya, kapuso, o kapatid, lahat tayo kasama. But all this will not happen without the active involvement of those in the informal sector of every Filipino in all walks of life. given the solid government commitment and strong regulatory environment to push for inclusive growth, the private sector, NGOs, people's organization, and civil society must bond together to achieve this goal in creating a multi-sectoral, community-based, self-help, incentives-linked, inclusive ecosystem-building movement via a bottom-up approach would make a huge difference. And generating a registered critical mass of at least 1 million enterprising Filipinos will be easy to achieve. We are creating an army of movers and builders that will make transformation happen. These efforts must be on ground, scalable, and targeted. Ang tunay na aksyon ay nasa mga komunidad. Kung paano lalo pa nila makakaramdaman ang mga benepisyong hatid ng teknolohiya. Actually, what we have so far done is what we call the Financial Inclusion Caravan. And we have started in Cebu and Iloilo. And we have schedules, in fact, up to next year in covering the entire country, covering second to third class municipalities around Philippines. So even those in the bottom of the pyramid have to take an active role. So imagine street vendors like Magtataho that who travels actually about 5 kilometers a day, or about those guys, no, na yung sino nagbibili ng taho dito araw-araw. Ayan. So ako Magtataho ko araw-araw. So the good thing there is that they know that they travel 5 kilometers a day to make lack of their taho, no. So just imagine they have their suki, they have their friends, relatives, etc. So if they will be able to make use of that network and make it viral, then they will definitely have other economic activity to make use of. So the thing here is that our magbabalot or tindera sa palengke or even those guys in the what we call the frontier economy will not be able to be part of this inclusive economic initiative that we are now, that we have actually launched in the BSP last September 6th. So, digital financial innovation have to be embraced by all. Creating a digital experience is basic to ensure the delivery of a delightful customer experience, but sustaining such experience is critical in gaining trust and loyalty. So no amount of marketing budget will beat the power of the word of mouth. If we want to provide affordable and greater access to finance and minimize the presence of informal lenders in the community, the better way to combat it would be to empower those people who are also in those localities. So this will make the cause of financial literacy viral amongst the residents in the barangay by becoming a Kasamaka community and income builder. So, how again do we address the issue of adoption? My humble answer would be to make it simple, simpleng gamitin, simpleng gawin, at simpleng intindihin. So, to further push to be simple in our messaging, I must say that the key to inclusive digital finance is tingi, or retail. The same model where fast-moving consumer goods or FMCGs like Unilever or P&G what I call FMCGing or sacheting financial services at the level of the retailers for quick adoption at the grassroots will enable vast majority of unbanked and underserved Filipinos to gain immediate credit footprint. In the process, we are unlocking the huge potential of the untapped 69% new-to-credit customers by bringing them to mainstream and formal financing services. We will have alternative ways to turn digital trails into financial track records to cover new-to-credit Filipinos. By leveraging on big data analytics and artificial intelligence, we will now be able to add our partner bank and non-banks with tools for quick credit decisioning, mitigating risk, and avoiding overextended borrowers. This will surely address the high cost of credit. Guided by the recent BSP enabling regulations, we will enable our over 1.2 million sari-sari stores nationwide and other establishments to become community digital hubs. This will be in collaboration with Liga ng Mga Barangay, DTI, Land Bank, and the DDP. Soon, everyone in Juana de la Cruz residing in any of over 42,000 barangays nationwide can have access to safe, seamless, affordable, fast digital financial services, may it be on savings, investment, insurance, loan, bill payments, layaway, or hulugan. Sari-sari store remain as the Filipinos' extension of every home, servicing at least 20 households each. The way to go is to be present in their everyday journey through the neighborhood point of sale. Dito sa Kimpoy, si yung aming Lupogi, si Empoy. Ito niya aming nilon, so kasama si Empoy. No? This is where the people in the community converge day in and day out. Yan yung chismisan, di ba? So, simply put, this is capacity building and people empowerment in the digital age. Together, we will accelerate our digital transformation. The benefits of financial inclusion are not only significant for individuals, but for the country's economic and social development in addressing poverty. At the end of all this, we want to measure all our efforts with positive outcomes. Sa simpleng salita, nais natin magkaroon ng kahinatnan ang layunin at mga gawain ito. Sa limang letrang P, may sasalarawan natin ang ating gustong makamit at may sakatuparan sa tulong ng lahat ng sektor ng lipunan. Ito ay ang pangkalatang pang-asenso ng Pilipino at pag-angat ng Pilipinas. At ngayon po, ipapakita namin sa inyo ang isang video that was shown at the BSP that was attended by over 500 sectoral representatives at the BSP Assembly Hall. Maraming salamat. Patuloy po ninyo ito.